few weeks, I have been very impressed with the publicity for Disney's Jungle Cruise movie. I feel they have gotten off to a tremendous start, largely due to The Rock's social media savvy. First, he posted that fun video of him and Emily Blunt goofing around on set, right? And then, just last week, he revealed the enormous, breathtaking set that's been built for the film and also included a wonderful ode to Walt Disney himself. It's all been going so well. But then, with this latest development yesterday, it seems as if this Jungle Cruise is headed for one hell of a waterfall. Is it too late to change course? I hope not, because again, I've been rooting for this movie lately, and this is just such a sad and unnecessary development. So what am I talking about? Well, as some of you I'm sure have seen, there was a headline yesterday out of the UK that straight comedian Jack Whitehall will be playing Disney's first, and this is their words, openly gay character who will be, and again I quote, very effete, very camp, and very funny. Now, I had to look up effete myself, and I can't believe it. It means weak, soft, delicate, and pampered. Yeesh, right? Now, of course, the focus of the controversy that I'm sure most of you have seen is that there's anger over a straight actor being cast to play an LGBT character. And we're going to address that. But I think an equally big problem is presenting a gay character not only stereotypically, but for laughs. We're going to break it all down. But what I want to touch on first is that I am absolutely shocked that Disney, which not only has had a legion of LGBT fans for quite some time, this isn't like something that's new for the company, right? And because they have such a large number of LGBT fans, a large number of people from that community work for Disney. So I can't believe that they would be so tone deaf as a company on how to handle LGBT characters. You would think that Disney would be the most nuanced and tuned in. Also, a weird note in the coverage has been that this is Jack Whitehall's biggest paycheck yet. Really? Like, I'm doing something incredibly offensive, but don't worry, I made bank doing it. And if you're wondering how much my soul costs, well, look at this paycheck. It's just a really weird thing to brag about. Now, on that note, if this is going to be a watershed moment for the gay community, and that's very much how it was presented in the coverage, like, oh my God, it's the first openly gay character in a Disney blockbuster, because I think that LeFou really didn't quite materialize, right? But, you know, and he's going to get paid a whole lot to do it, right? Shouldn't that moment be brought to life by a member of the LGBT community rather than having them just sit in the audience and watch a straight guy do it? If you can't see how the optics on that are a problem, I think you should think about it a little bit more, right? Like, hey, congratulations, guys and men and women in the LGBT community. Look what we're doing up there. You're not a part of it at all, but don't you appreciate it? It's like, what? Now, of course, as many of you are pointing out, the definition of an actor is that they should be able to have, well, actually, in fact, that's not true. Some actors, like leading actors particularly, it helps them not to have any range, right? But, you know, the idea is that an actor should be able to act, to bring any character to life, right? But let's not forget that in the very beginning of the theater, right, when it was with the Greeks, white men, or Greek men, played all the roles, even the women. Do you want to go back to that if we're going to use that argument, right? And I'd also like to say that just as we're learning behind the camera with better representation, better diversity in the writing and directing, etc., there's something to be said for having someone from the group being depicted contribute to said depiction. I'm not in favor of pushing out everyone else from telling the story. You know, movie making is a team effort. So you can have lots of different people who are involved. And so I think that should be the case, particularly when you're telling a particular story. And I think if they had had an LGBT person, you know, in this role, that person would have pointed out that this would be a really huge mistake to make that person, that character, a walking stereotype, again, for comedic effect. It just seems so odd. See, I would think that anyone would realize this, but apparently there's a whole bunch of people working on Jungle Cruise that didn't get it. So on that note, one of my reactions when I first read this headline was, well, who the heck wrote this movie, right? Well, it turns out it was a lot of people. But two of them are Glenn Ficarra and John Requa, who've done the exact same thing before, including the straight casting with I Love You, Philip Morris, a film that not only flopped financially, but didn't set the critical world on fire either. And what I'm saying there is I don't really see any incentive to repeat this. Like, wow, that show worked out swell. Let's do it again, but on a bigger level. You're like, it's just going to be even bigger, an even bigger disaster. And also, that movie was made a while back. You know, like, people will point to successful, instances that seem to back up an argument, but you have to pay attention to how things are moving forward and evolving, right? Just because something was exciting when it happened, like someone could say, oh, well, it's so big, such a big deal that Tom Hanks, for instance, played not only a gay character in Philadelphia, but one fighting, you know, dealing with AIDS, right? But the point was is that you needed a straight actor to get mainstream audiences to see that, right? But that's not a problem anymore. Mainstream audiences are very open to LGBT characters. So then you have to move on to the next step. You can't just stay in place. That's, I think, very important. Now, when it comes to this Jungle Cruise movie, I think this is a problem on two fronts. With the way the character's being depicted. Now, if this is supposed to be representation for the LGBT audience, and you're doing it in a big Disney movie that's a family movie, a lot of kids are gonna be going with their families, well, for the LGBT kids, how does that help them in terms of representation to see everyone else in the audience laughing at the character that represents them, right? And then if you flip it to the other side with all the straight kids in the audience, right, what are you teaching them? That it's okay and fun to laugh at effeminate gay people, and that's the only type of gay person that there is, LGBT person there is? I think it's destructive on both fronts. Now, the article, to be fair, did point out that at the time that this Jungle Cruise movie is supposed to be taking place, the LGBT community was obviously not very, you know, open and accepted by society, right? And let's see if the movie reflects that nuance. But I don't see how it can if Jack Whitehall's character is wearing his sexuality on his lace sleeves, as the movie basically is saying. I mean, it's been a long time since Birdcage, both the original French film in the 1970s, and of course the Hollywood remake, right? And there have been so many instances like that at this point, you know, on television, you know, beaming into people's homes and on their cell phones, right? I mean, the next step with LGBT characters is to present ones that are not defined solely by their sexuality. That's what was so exciting about Love, Simon. But unfortunately, nobody went to see that damn movie. It was such a great film, and I think it was such a great step forward that nobody witnessed. And this is instead what they're going to see. It's very, very sad. I mean, I would prefer that this character be like, say, the professor on Gilligan's Island, right? Who didn't love the professor? And maybe a clever, subtle giveaway to his sexuality is that when you're already far into the film and you've already come to know his character and he's awesome and he's, you know, one of many heroic moments, he needs to concentrate. So he turns to The Rock and very politely says, could you please put your shirt back on? That would be, I think, funny. It would be subtle. It would be clever. It would be new. It would be a genuine step forward. I think that's the way to go, obviously, and I can't believe that Disney doesn't, especially considering their fandom and the people who work at their company, don't understand that. I think that's going to make for some real awkward company discussions and screenings, quite frankly. So what do you think of the situation now that we've discussed it? Maybe I've changed your mind a little bit, or if you feel that I've got it wrong, I'd be interested to hear your counter argument down below. I feel I really got a lot of you with that, you know, men playing all the roles in the beginning of theater with the Greeks. Although I think ironically, of course, LGBT was very open in the Greek society, right? In many ways, they felt they didn't need women for anything, but it's very interesting. And, I'd be very curious to hear your thoughts down below. And of course, as always, you can check out some more videos right now.